How do we get from point A to point B? It is pretty common nowadays to see this kind of perforated honeycomb mouse design. This reduces weight while retaining most of the structural strength. In this design, the honeycomb pattern is restricted to certain regions of the body. In this tutorial, I will not be modeling the whole mouse. The focus will be on how to selectively mask areas of a pattern feature. We have the basic shape of the mouse here. This is shelled on the inside. The workflow can be summarized as follows. Before creating the perforations, we will need to create a copy of the body in the exact same location. On the original body, we will create a honeycomb pattern that covers most of the top surface of the mouse. It is important that the area of this starting pattern exceeds what we actually need. On the copied body, we will cut out the regions where we need the honeycomb patterns to be visible. This will serve as the masking body. Lastly, we will combine the two bodies. The two most critical steps in this workflow are the copying of the original body and the combining thereafter. Let's go into detail in each of these steps. First, we need to create a copy of the existing body. Go to the browser, locate the body, and select it. Ctrl-C to copy, and Ctrl-V to paste. At this point, the Move Copy window shows up. Click OK to place a copy in the exact same position as the original. Take note that if you access the Move Copy command from Modify, this does not allow us to copy a body in the exact same location. The only option here is to copy and paste. Rename both bodies and hide the copy for the moment. We shall create the perforations on the original body. I'm going to create a honeycomb pattern on the top plane, which is situated about a third from the base. The starting seed pattern consists of two hexagons at an angle from each other. Go to Create, Rectangular Pattern. Window select the two hexagons as the objects. Drag out the horizontal arrow. Adjust the quantity and spacing. Do the same for the vertical direction. It is important to ensure that this initial pattern exceeds what we actually need. Confirm the pattern. Window select all the profiles and begin the extrude tool. For extend, select all. And the cut would extend all the way to the top surface of the body, following the curvature. This seems like a bit of a mess at the moment, but we do not need to worry about that, as a combine command later will patch those up nicely. Next, hide the current body and unhide the copy. Looking at the final model, you can see that we need to review the honeycomb pattern only in certain regions. Let's create a sketch on the top plane to define this region. The outer profile consists of arcs and straight lines. The inner profile is a circle. this is the region where we need the pattern to be reviewed. So select that profile and create a cut. Let's unhide the original body. You can see areas where the excess honeycomb pattern overlap with the copied body. Once we perform the combine command, these overlapping volumes would fuse together, leaving no trace of the honeycomb pattern. Go to Modify, Combine. The previous cut has split the copied body into two separate bodies, one of which is a cylinder. So select all three bodies from the browser. For operation, select Join and Confirm. There are going to be some areas which are not aesthetically pleasing. In this case, you can select the face and delete. Another method is to go back into the rectangular pattern. Look out for the rectangular pattern icon. Right-click and edit. You can selectively suppress instances of the pattern by unchecking the tick boxes. Do note that in this case, every instance consists of two hexagons. For those of you who want to try this out, there is no need to try to replicate the shape of the model that you see here. You can create a simple plate to try this. The most important thing here is to understand the concept and the purpose of each step. So do have fun trying. I will see you in the next one.